Welcome.
You're gonna take on to the game.
All right. All right.
That's it. Watch the mic. Well, if your sister goes down, and I'm sorry, John, we only got a couch tonight.
It's okay. What up with that?
In fact, I believe that after your 7 days in bed there, you felt so tired you wanted to come home and go to bed.
Well, we thought the fact from 10 in the morning to 10 at night to try and get peace through the heads, and so we didn't have much rest in.
Well, now, let me ask you what you've been asked as you came back. Just what, you know, what were you after? What is this all about? What are you trying to achieve by doing these extraordinary, bizarre things, you and Yoko?
Well, everything we do is aimed at peace, you know. And we spent 7 days trying to communicate through the communication media, that's the press and TV, and to try and tell people who are interested in protesting to do something about it instead of sitting at home talking about it. And for the ones that are doing it in the streets, the only result is front page mirror of policemen getting kicked and or students getting kicked. And there's many ways of protesting. One is you can grow your hair. This is the most functional and suitable way of protesting. Yeah, the people we are. Now, I think any organization can give up 1 week of their holiday, which is what we did. You know, it wasn't a fact of anybody, you know, you wouldn't afford to stay in the Hilton. You can do it anyway.
Yeah, doing it with this objective. What does it do for you? What does it do for Yoko? What would do?
It's an event, you know, of all the happenings that people know them better. And it was just like
stage show, you know.
I think so, very good, because we got a very good response from people, and I knew that we weren't just a stay,
you know, there are many people in the world who feel the same way
about
us.
There's not many lessons to think about us. You said to me the other evening when you came back from Amsterdam, John, that you didn't really care, or
worse,
whether people thought you were nuts or not, if you got them thinking.
Yeah, we're willing to be the world's freaks, you know. Mm. The world's like a party that's a bit depressing and a bit heavy. And everybody's too serious.
But do you feel that the thoughts you've got them thinking now have been helpful thoughts?
Yeah, I mean, there's the old woman that raced along the day who's saying she's the best laugh you've had in her life, you know. Well, that was enough for me, you know. She wanted to say something.
Let me ask the audience here now. This was your objective. May I ask you, may I get a camera on the audience? Are there any of you here, and please don't be afraid to put your hands up, who have thought more about peace because of any of the things that John and Yoko have done? So anyway,
thank you.
Somebody there, put around. Somebody here in the front row. Can we get a microphone, say, here? Can we get a microphone to front row here, for instance? Oh, somebody who's putting up their hand. I want to see something. Thank you. Sorry. Can you tell me how this made you think more about Peter?
Well, I thought he was the biggest piece of rubbish that I've ever seen. Actually, but when reading the story of them both being in this bag, I did actually wonder as to whether they were refugees from the Lambeth busing strike.
Did I have a laugh?
I think the example you set to some of the children and youngsters was nothing to laugh at.
What do you think was wrong with two people staying in bed?
The fact that you stayed in bed, there's nothing wrong with that. In fact, if you stayed there longer, I think it would be better for everybody.
Okay, don't get on stage with me. You're looking at me before you get insulted. I hope it's not offended you about what we do.
Well, I'm sure I don't mind looking in the mirror. I think I see something better than looking at you.
Well, what's the matter with you? A matter of personal taste now. What offended you basically? Can you really tell me what bugs you?
Well, not just the one item alone, your general attitude. Your general attitude to the youngsters in this country, the way you lead them or attempt to lead them and try to make out that you're not doing anything about it. Why don't you tell us that you're trying to create peace in this world and everybody should be happy and joking, and the next minute you're telling us it's nothing. Whether these youngsters take cannibals or anything like this is all nothing. This part of the story doesn't count.
If you want to tell us all about this peace you want to do, what about some of the other things you're doing?
Well, have you done anything for peace? I mean, particularly, do you think that you've done something for peace?
Yes, I think I have.
What have you done?
Well, during the last war, you know, there were many... During the last war, we spent our time trying to get peace.
Did you take your own volition? Did you volunteer?
Did I volunteer? Yes, I did.
Oh, well, congratulations.
Oh, no,
what are you doing now?
Did it make you think that you could do something about peace in the world as you did?
Right.
Thank you.
John, somebody right behind you though wants to say something.
It's a symbol of growth. And if you plant acorns, the tree will grow, but if you bomb it, it won't.
No.
Where did you come from? Jam Jazz.
Let me come back to John here. We're trying to get a view there.
Yes.
And here's John, the Beatles, 5 years ago. What do you think John of 5 years ago would think of John Lennon now? Is, you know, 69.
Seriously,
5 years ago of now. I mean, the
I can't imagine, you know. I mean, I thought pretty much the same then. Only I was younger.
So. Yeah. So your thoughts, you feel, haven't changed. It's just that you've had a chance of expressing them, isn't it?
Yes. You know, and I'm less. I'm not myself, maybe in the last 5 years ago. It's kind of. Before Hard Day's Night, I was me. After that, I was some kind of people, you know.
Do you feel that enough people are getting something serious out of what you're doing, or are they reacting to it like this gentleman here, it's just another stunt, what kind of an idiot is this?
Well, you get both, you know. You get both, and you get the majority of people that were not really... We can't attempt to communicate with people like him, because it doesn't work, you know. But we got through to a lot of people, you know, really. And even if we get through to five out of this lot, that's enough, you know. It's better than not getting through to that five.
I mean, why do you think, now this man in the front row is quite vehement, why do you think so many people seem to have turned against the Beatles? There's an article which is very favorable in America. Why have we turned against the Beatles and about you, your Google? Why do you think people...
Because, we and the public, and the press, we do is create an image of people, or the Beatles, or anybody else. And then when you don't conform to the image, they get upset, you know. As if we belong to them in that respect, and we don't.
Yeah.
And I don't intend to go around the night looking like help on our days. I just suit other people's view of me. You know, as soon as we get to a point where you can't answer, you have to be sort of satirical about it. Well, you know. There's nothing to say about that.
Yes.
I don't believe in killing people.
I don't believe in taking oneself so seriously.
I'm not that serious, or I wouldn't be in God doing an event like that, would I? Thank you.
There is a kind of contradiction. I mean, when you say take him, he's obviously very serious about the peace thing, but at the same time he's saying if he can get someone to laugh at him, he's not objecting to that.
Mm-hmm. I think the people that we follow, mainly are people like Gandhi and Martin Luther King, and unfortunately they get killed. Now, we're the only people that have tried the same guilt with humor, and I think the establishment or whoever it is that kills these people don't know how to handle humor. And so I have just as much sense of humor as you, probably more.
Jack, you're a laughter maker. Have you ever, say, cracked a gag with a view to not just making a laugh, but making a laugh plus with some political or moral purpose?
No, I don't get into the political field for laughter. Or ridiculing anybody in politics. I have some true stories that have happened with politicians that are funny and they're nice and they get laughed with. But I would like to ask Mr. Lemon, and I'm merely asking this.
Go on, you Jack.
I'm merely asking this because I just want to know. You know, I'm not trying to be facetious, and I mean, does this all stem from the war in Vietnam?
No, this is just the violence. I think the war in Vietnam is a manifestation of the whole of the world's violence. I think Hitler and the Germans were not the only ones to blame. I think it's a manifestation of man's violence. So of course I'm protesting against Vietnam, but also London or anywhere else that violence is happening.
Well, sir, another wink of deep for another theory. Our thanks to Gary Jones. Good night to Ralph Harris, Jack Benny, the Hoodie Man, John and Yoko.
Thank you all.